Okay, guys, we are in for one tough matter today. Start off just by destroying the base to your south, which you can do with just your cat's bolts. It isn't really guarded by anything, and you don't want to lose any ghouls or crypt fiends. So for now, head north with all your units, and don't forget to grab the two sacrificial skulls. That way you can put down some things like crypt and ziggurats while you're waiting for your gold mine and your necropolis to build. Now, most guys suggest you take the gold mine that's in that base to the south, but I actually prefer taking this one here, because you can set up your necropolis and a line of ziggurats to use as defensive structures, which will basically defend you from any attacks that might come during the course of the mission. So the main advantage to having your defensive structures there means that the obelisk on the left is far easier to defend from Illidan. You see, you can draw Illidan to the western. see if Illidan goes to capture that obelisk, it's easy enough to draw him away and draw him into your defensive structures, so they take care of him, and then he has to like revive and everything, and it just means that no matter what, Illidan will not take all four obelisks. That being said, this mission becomes a lot easier if you try and be quick rather than trying to draw it out. Now, Illidan doesn't have a set path to take any of the obelisks. He will go pretty much at random, but he will always take the north one first. And as we've discussed previously, the computer is a cheating bitch. While they all look like they're being protected by various ice revenants, actually only three of them are. The top one only looks like it's being protected because there are only two revenants there. So Illidan will set up a base there, which we'll have to destroy later, but we'll get to that when it comes down to it. For now, just continue setting up your base, making sure to get in a graveyard, a crypt, and definitely do not forget an altar of darkness. You also want to make sure that as soon as your necropolis is done, start upgrading it to a Halls of the Damned. For now, you don't need to worry about saturating the gold mine. Three acolytes will be plenty. You can get the extra two in once the Halls of the Damned is completed. As long as you watch your base and make sure that none of them get killed, you won't need to build any more ghouls for this mission. But once you finally get your graveyard in, start upgrading creature attack and defense. For now, we're only going to be building things like crypt fiends, but also make sure to research webs so they can take down any flying units. Now, unlike Illidan, who seems to be completely random as to when and where he will attack, the Elf base to the north and the Naga base to the south will both attack at set times with set units. The first attack from the red base comes within 5 minutes, and they will have ballistas, so watch out for them. You should be able to take care of it without losing a single unit, though. Now, what usually happens here is Illidan will attack one of the obelisks, in which case you need to chase him down. But for me, he happened to attack my base here, which probably gave me an advantage in the early game. So what you want to do is focus him down with your spirit towers, and the southern Naga base will attack you as well at this point. For some reason they decided to attack the obelisk instead of going to my base, and they got eliminated by the ice revenants that were there. But their first attack consists of things you can take down with your spirit towers and your two meat wagons. Now, I've said it before and I'm going to say it again. The computer is a cheating bitch. While the Elf and the Naga bases probably won't build anything that you can't handle with quite easily, Illidan will read what units you're building and then build the counter to that unit. So if you build lots of Frostworms, he's going to build a lot of Coertles. And Coertles, as we've said before, all of the Naga units are OP as shit. So you gotta be careful. That being said, we are actually going to be building a lot of Frostworms, so not quite yet. Get yourself a sacrificial pit and two boneyards and get the upgrade for the Frostworms. That is kind of essential. For now though, just keep building crypt fiends so that we can attack Illidan when he attacks the obelisks. Thus is the basic strategy I use to beat this mission. Simple as this. Wait for Illidan to attack an obelisk. When he's weakened by the ice revenants, you kill him and then take the obelisk. Illidan will never go after the same obelisk twice in a row, so what you can do, and this is completely optional, you can either leave the obelisk undefended and attack Illidan if he comes to attack it later, or you can set up static defenses and a necropolis and a gold mine and defend it with Stag D. Now, using this strategy is good for a couple of reasons. It allows Arthas to level back up very quickly, and it means you can dictate the pace of the battle instead of having to react to what the AI does. might be a good idea also to use one of your level ups to get Death Pact for Arthas, because it means you can use any of the animated dead that you make to heal him back up. He won't have very much health to start off with. His stats are pretty bad at level 2. Anubarak's ultimate spell is also very useful in this mission. It can be used to take out entire groups of enemies that don't have any hero or magic support. So just bear that in mind. Now, all four groups of Ice Revenants do have a special item that you can grab, but the only one that's really that useful is Talisman of Evasion that you can get from the southern one. It's not a big deal if you manage to lose Arthas while fighting Illidan while grabbing the next obelisk, but if you do, work around it. You can always revive him at the Altar of Darkness. If Illidan manages to capture an obelisk, he will start setting up a base around it, and if you let him do that, it's going to be impossible to take it back. So eliminate him, eliminate all the buildings that start creating, and then you won't have a problem when you come back to it later, or, you know, if you manage to keep Arthas alive here. Be careful when Kael'thas attacks your base too, because this flame strike will do devastating damage to your spirit towers. You can interrupt the casting of flame strike by using Impale that Anubarak has. If you do it quick enough, it means the flame strike won't hit, and you will waste all that mana without having done any damage. You can then focus him down with your spirit towers. The same principle also applies if you get attacked by Lady Varsh using her whirlwind attack. So, hopefully you've captured two of the obelisks by now and Illidan has only got one. While he's attacking the third one, if you haven't managed to lure him into your base already, or if you just want to take him out here, you can do. Kill him, kill his minions, and then take the obelisk straight away. As soon as you've taken the second obelisk, that is when you want to start building Frostworms, because then they can be used to take out the last base, and you won't get too many Coertles. Whereas if you build them too early, you'll have way too many Coertles to even be able to deal with it. And if you've been keeping up with your upgrades, you should have Web, you should have level 3 attack and defense for creatures, you should have a good amount of Crypt Fiends at this point, and of course gotten the Frost Nova for the Frostworms. And as soon as you've taken that third obelisk, you want to take every unit you've got, every Ghoul, every Crypt Fiend, every Frostworm, and go and attack that base that's surrounding the fourth obelisk. You want to attack this base as soon as you can, while Illidan is still respawning. The enemies will be fewer in number, and it will be so much easier to take down, because if Illidan isn't respawning, he'll have this little personal army come join him, and it's almost impossible to take this down, considering how strong that the Naga are. So using your spells, using your skills, using all the abilities that you've managed to build, getting up to this point, take that base out. Focus down as many of the units as you can to start off with, and then once you felt like you've killed enough, take three Frostworms and attack one on each of the buildings, each of the static defenses that surround the obelisk circle of magic. Now by this point Illidan will have respawned and is probably about to attack you, or is off going to get one of the other obelisks. If that does happen, it doesn't matter. Long as you keep Arthas alive during that last thing, there is no way you can lose. And that's it. Thanks for watching. This is the end of the mission. This is the end of the campaign. This is the end of the guide. This is it. I have nothing left to say here apart from I believe in you. Thank you for watching. And never eat yellow snow.